I'm Alicia Rasmussen, and I'm so glad that God chose me to be a part of the Rasmussen family and to fulfill their mission and vision. And I'm really blessed that I am a part of such a family who is obeying God's will and is walking every day step towards heaven and His ways and His thoughts in our mind. So I think when this ministry was started by our grandfathers, they really had a big dream that what they want from here. And I'm thankful to God that He has put it in our hearts that we can fulfill that dream. And I think that God has chosen everyone for a specific reason. I think my dad, Frank, has been chosen to expand the hospital, and we have seen amazing changes in the hospital. So I feel my calling is to expand the school, because I'm really into the education sector, and I think academics is my forte. I have been really interested in teaching and academics from the very beginning. So I want to really expand the school. I want to see it at a greater place. So right now I'm working with the ministry, and I'm working as assistant manager. I look to the administration of the school, as well as I do preach sometimes in the church, and I want God to fill me more with the Spirit, to understand His words more. I think He has blessed me with understanding, and I just want to walk in His ways and fulfill His dreams. Thank you. He did not do it for anybody else. Just one worldly responsibility that only was for a woman, for Mother Mary. So, and I don't know why people think that women are subsided. And they did a lot of work. Mary Magdalene, she preached, the women we were discussing about, the Samaritan women. She started preaching about Jesus. So women have always received favors, and even like from among the many followers of Jesus, women were also there. They also prayed and performed miracles. So I don't know why people think about cultural differences. And like, as Mom read in the book of Galatians, nor Jew nor Gentile, nor men and women, we all are one in Christ. So I think we all are children of God, and we need, and anything which is not focused on Christ, and anything, I can understand there are people are different culturally because we belong to different countries, but something which is like Nancy was discussing about, they were told that it is mandatory to cover their head. It's written in the Bible just for the Corinthians, and you know, we need to understand why it was told to them. And Paul, just after that, Paul says it's something which we can discuss about, and it is not mandatory. If you wish, you do it, and I'm not forcing this upon you. I'm telling you to do this. This is nothing which is mandatory. So it's more culture of a country, but we cannot judge people by what they wear and they have to wear. Yes, only Timothy tells us to wear modest clothes, and that's just about covering ourselves. That's not about being specific that what should I wear and what should I not wear, because what I wear and what how I look like, it's not going to decide whether I belong to His kingdom or not. It's in my heart. So as the book says, like, fasting of mind and heart is better than fasting of the body. So cleaning of mind and heart and understanding the word from mind and heart is better than doing favors for the body. But doing favors for spiritual life is more important to receive a place in His kingdom. So I don't know what more to say. Would you like to say something?
Yes, it's true. Like we were discussing, this doesn't matter we belong to which country, what we wear, what we eat, how we look, what is our color. As important is what we believe and what we follow, actually. We believe and what we follow. And actually we believe and follow that or not. अब स्टिल वी आर फॉलोइंग ऑल ओल्ड थिंग्स एंड देन वेयर इज क्राइस्ट सेक्रीफाइस इफ वी स्टिल इन दैट बिकॉज इट्स रिटन इफ यू आर फॉलोइंग अ सिंगल थिंग ऑफ टोरा देन यू विल बी जज बाय दैट एंड नो वन कैन बी परफेक्ट बाय दैट इफ इट इज देन वेयर इज क्राइस्ट इफ वी बिलीव इन दैट the god his plan for us when he sended his forgotten son due to that ki we all can be saved and we all can get the right of that before we were nothing we were without god because at the time jesus christ didn't complete his work till then we were separated from god there was one veil in front of us because when at the time Moses used to go to talk to God then when he used to come back then at the time he used to cover his head and the face because his face used to
eliminated
and then he used to tell the people what God has said but now after Christ is the, I think, is a God present himself through him in front of all mankind. What is God? And what is his plan? And still we are just in a, that before that veil, still we are just not understanding the plan of God.
I think
we cannot see directly.
Book of Ephesians, it's written.
Yeah.
The freedom we have received is the gift of God.
God.
I think it's written in Ephesians.
Yes. And he says that the burden is less.
My yoke is less
weighted. And still we want to carry that heavy weight. And or we want to carry this light and simple and beautiful and the with the eternal life. What do you want? Actually it's depending on you. Still you believe that you are boy and you are girl, we are black, we are white, you are Christian, we are not this and that, there's a lot of things. Today is full moon, today is half moon, today is dipping is necessary. And there's a lot of things we carry. Today is Monday, today is Saturday, today is Tuesday, today is that day. What, still we are in that? Or we are free from that? Because God has given this chance to be free by this scripture, by Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ did all for us, all sacrifices are completed, and we are free and we are children of God. We are no, I think so. We are no women and men and anything, because when we think man and woman, there's always is from the very beginning is a man shows that they are the in power. There's a people says that they are different from the very beginning, but now, after Christ, there is no difference. We are in front of God. We all are one, children of God. That's the basic thing I want to tell you.
So many things about written.
I can say so many things R and R, but
see,
I think so.
Even in the Proverbs,
it's good enough. I think so.
Proverbs explains a good woman. Proverbs doesn't explain a good man. It explains what a good woman should be. A wife is considered as a blessing of God.
Yes.
A good wife is a blessing from God. It's not written about man. It's written about women. It's written about wife. So why do we consider ourselves? Some people may be offended, and some are actually sometimes when, you know, we are in conversation, that I am too young to say all these things, and I do not understand the culture because I'm so young that I cannot preach to other people. But you know,
yes.
I just want to tell them, like, it's if I'm young, I can still preach, because you know, in the book of Ecclesiastes, it's written you should remember your Creator in the days of your youth.
Yes.
And in the book of Timothy, it's written, no one should look down upon you because you're young. And I think God always wants a young spirit in us. It's how I've understood it. It's written in 1 John, if I suppose. If our spirit is young, we are strong and we have overcome the world. So that's why I would like to convey to those people also who think I'm too young, they should read scripture properly. And there's no difference between man and women. According to Bible, it's something which human has created. It's not something which God has created. God loves their children equally, be it girl, be it a boy. Otherwise, God would not have blessed women and not blessed men. And that's why we have to say.